I titled my message, Faith in the Prophetic is More Than Confidence in What God Will Do. Amen. Faith in the prophetic is more than having confidence in what God will do or what God is going to do. I'll tell you simple that we had people of Israel, in the Israel, who had faith in God for what God will do. But as they have faith in God for what to do, they were not prophetic. Amen. The people of Israel believed in God and went into battle. But the majority of them that went into battle, and when they consulted God, and they said, God say they are going to win the battle, and they follow, and they went to the battle, and they won. At that time, the Holy Spirit was not even living in them. So we cannot call those people prophetic people. But there's no prophetic people that have spirit living in him. I'm not talking about the prophet God used. I'm talking about the people who believed. Okay? Okay. I'll go to another one. Demons. Demons believe that God will exist. Amen? They know what God is going to do, but they are not in the prophetic. So there's another dimension of faith we are going to see today. Amen? Another dimension of faith we are going to see today that is going to help us. Hallelujah. Okay, faith and true faith. When I say faith and true faith, first of all, I'm going to give the definition of faith that we have in the Bible. Hebrew 11, verse 1. That says, faith is the confidence that what we hope for will actually happen. It gives us assurance about things we cannot see, which is true. That's a simple faith. But do you know that sometimes you can have that faith, but it will not happen? Amen? Thank you. Follow me very well. Faith that limits itself in what God can do, amen, can be devastating. Hallelujah. I know. Rana said, what this guy is going to bring out today again. Good. Faith in the prophetic require knowing the purpose of what God wants to do. If God announced something to you and tell you this is what you want to do, if you don't know why God wants to do it and the purpose of it, it may come and you mismanage it. Okay? God, when the God start doing the things, you mismanage it. I won't go far. Wait. You see, most of the time we say to ourselves, oh God, please give me this power. But before you are saying, God, give me this power, you have your agenda for the power of God you are requiring. Maybe it's because you want to demonstrate that, help God, demonstrate that God is powerful. So you see some case, you are saying, oh, I wish I can have this power of God. So I can do this. Maybe people who are be healed, people can be believing God. But is that the plan of God? Is that what God wants to do? So faith is more than having confidence. You need to know what God wants to do before he announces. If you don't know what God wants to do before he announces, he may give the things, but you may destroy the plan of God, or you may do something very, very bad. Hallelujah. Amos 3:7 says, Indeed, the sovereign Lord never does anything until he reveals his plan to his servant, the prophet. It is our duty to take time to seek understanding for the reason behind the plan. Hallelujah.
the reason behind the plan. No, I'm telling you, you are going to get it. Amen? So now we understand the motive behind the promise of God. Quicker, he will deliver. So most of the time, God announces, but we wait, and the things never happen because he knew that as our heart never change, our mind never catch his will of what he wants to do, when he puts it in our hand, we cannot manage it. He said he never gives his gifts or his power to people the power is going to discern. God may tell you, I'm going to give you money. And immediately you start planning, oh, I'll have 5 cars. I'll have this. But God has purpose for your money, for the money. Ask God, what will you do? What do you want me to do with it? Hallelujah. What do you want me to do with it? And most of the time, parents are failing to do in Christianity. When you are asking for a child or you feel you are pregnant, immediately start asking God, what is the purpose of this child in my house, in this life? Hallelujah. Amen. So, knowing the reason behind the action of God leads us into better preparation and wise management of the gift, promise, or blessing. Hallelujah. It's because David knew that Solomon is going to be king. That's why Solomon had been prepared in consequence. Hallelujah. So, if you just know that somebody is going to be king, or like God told David that Solomon is going to be the king after you, and you say, okay, as God says, God will do it, and just fold your arm like this. You may lose the kingship yourself. Because if somebody else is ready to do it, God will do it through that person. Amen? So some people have never got some of the promises come through because their stubbornness stopped the preparation. Pride took people away from the root of the preparation. Because as soon as God announced the things that I'm going to do this with you, immediately you are looking down on others. Oh, don't worry. When God will do it, you will see. We will see here. We will see. We will see what? That's not the mind of God. Hallelujah. And some people in this country, God announced to them, I'm going to give you status, what we call paper, in this country or in the other country. But God wants them to serve him. But they are not interested in that preparation to serve God. But now they plan, let this paper come so I can have this job, I can make this money. And the paper is delaying. The paper is delaying. At the end of the day, they will say, okay, the person who gives the promises or the person who releases the prophecy is the one who deliver a wrong prophecy. No. The prophecy came out. The purpose of the prophecy, did you seek it? Have you prepared for it? Have you met God where he wants you to meet you? Hallelujah. We are going to get this very well. Don't worry. Laziness sometimes as well makes people fall behind the manifestation of the plan of God. As soon as God announces it, they just go, Balaam announced something. That's very good. Say, whatever God says, for sure he will deliver. He's not a man of God, a man to lie, or a son of man to say what that will not fulfill what he promised. Huh? Hallelujah. Look, Hebrews 11, verse 12 to 13 say, therefore, from one man, and him as good as dead, were born as many as the star of the sky in multitude, innumerable as the sand which is by the seashore. Talking about Abraham. This all, talking about all the people of the faith, this all
die in faith, not having received the promises. The hope for it, they believe with all their heart, but it never happens. Because if your mind never changes toward the plan of God, the promises of God, it will never happen. Because God doesn't want to destroy you. Amen? Hallelujah? So true faith is patience. When you are really faithful or you have faith in something, as you have assurance that it's going to happen, you are patient. You are not worrying about the things anymore. You are not happy praying, asking, doing this and that anymore. Amen? So the waiting time is for the preparation and understanding of the reason behind the plan of the future action of God. Amen? Most of the time, Christian, if you remember, Jesus said something. I have no problem with my people when they are lacking in poverty. But when they start profiting financially, if just they can serve me again, if just they can worship me again, that means when God wants to give the money, release the money, a lot of people, we have our mindset. We haven't got our mind changed yet. It's a renewal of the mind. When you have it, so your mind now matches with the mind of God. Your plan, the way you reason, match with the way God reason. Then when the money comes, the way we use it is that Jesus is using the money on earth. So most of people, they have a lot of things, promises to them. Oh, I remember, I went in Ghana some years ago in Accra. I was doing pastor conference. When I finished the conference, one pastor came to me. He said, God revealed the globe to him. How are you going to travel, going here, going there, going there, going there, going there, and preaching all over the world? I said, fantastic. But now the senior pastor came to me. He said, he bought a land. He gave to this guy to go and start church. He doesn't want to start church. What he wants all the churches to be there. So every church will be inviting him. He just go and preach. Go and preach. But if you don't start yourself and build one and get the experience out of everything, how can you, out of building that one, how can you help others? Because when people are having problems, you don't know how that problem can be solved. You haven't experienced it. So I told him, have you, because at that time there were 9 churches together that came to, the senior pastor is leading 9 churches. So I told him, okay, have you started lead any cell group or anything? Say no. Say, start there. But he doesn't wonder, because his mind said, what God say, the promise is so good, but the roots, he want to jump. Hallelujah. Amen. So, mature prophet, mature in the prophetic understand the motive behind the promises of God. They understand. They don't just announce. That's why the mature in the prophetic, they don't never release prophecy that they know that it can destroy any of their spiritual children. If somebody is mature, you know that, God revealed right now. This one, the way pride is in him. If I tell him this now, he will never tell you. Until you see the pride is gone. Until you see that nothing is there that can destroy it, so he can release it. Amen? So, if faith is not just having confidence, real faith is not just having confidence in what God is going to do, but is having confidence, understanding the purpose of it, and preparing for it. Amen? Then let's look at the true righteousness.
Because I say righteousness. Amen. My righteous will live by faith. So somebody who's truly righteous is somebody who can see what God wants to do and dedicate his life in order to achieve it the way God wants to achieve it. Amen. Let's just put it this way. Noah heard a boat, a flood is coming. And Noah said, God, you are so powerful. Flood is coming. Let's pray. Family, come. Let's fast. Let's pray. A boat is going to appear. Preparation for what is coming. There is a purpose why God sow that word in you. Amen? He said, my righteous will live by faith. But I will take no pleasure in anyone who turn away. That means you must focus on it. You must focus. And say, but we are not like those who turn away from God to their own destruction. To their own destruction. We are the faithful ones whose soul will be saved. So true righteousness is then seeing what God wants to do and getting ready for its execution. For its execution. Hallelujah. We look at it here. Anna. If your need does not meet the need of God, is that you are wasting time. Most of the time, we hear this false teaching. That say, God will do this for you. Hallelujah. Amen. I take it. I claim it. I just say, yeah. Amen. Another one will say this here. No. Say, breakthrough, your dream. All these are the tree of knowledge of good and bad. Because the person who prophesies in the thing know what is good, know what you want to hear. When you are prophesying, you don't know anything. It's the Spirit of God that will declare the thing through you, and your sons will be surprised. Sometimes when God, the Spirit of God will declare for you, say, huh? Amen? But when you want just to give prayer, pray, wishing things, so you are operating from the tree of knowledge and good and bad. But when you are operating from the tree of knowledge of life, let me tell you this. Now, this Sunday we are going to have place. Do you know what? You know that the tree of life was no sin. Adam and Eve never seen that tree. The tree was in the garden, but they never seen it. But only the tree of knowledge and good and bad can be seen, isn't it? Don't worry. We'll get it Sunday, okay? Hallelujah. So, a prophetic ministry is really profitable to a church or in a church when it is mature. Mature prophet does not seek vision or revelation. Father, give me vision. Father, give me revelation. No. You don't do that. Pushing for revelation makes us easily fall into divination. Hallelujah. A coconut tree never worry about whether it will produce coconut or not. So when you are a prophet, why are you praying for revelation? Why are you praying for prophecy? Coconut tree or mango tree. What is it? When my season comes, I will give mango. No. Touch me. Okay? Let the season come, you will see mangoes. Let the season come, you will see coconuts full of water. A sweet one. Amen? Like Psalm 1, verse 1 to 3 says, blessed are the man who walk in the counsel of the ungodly. No. Blessed is the man who walk not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stand in the path of the sinners, nor sit in the seat of the mockers. But he delights
in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the river of water that brings forth its fruit in its season. So when you are a prophet, when the demonstration of power is needed, the time to demonstrate that God's power is there, the power will come out of you. When you are prophets, when the time to prophesy is there, the prophecy will come out of you. You don't worry about it. Amen? But now, mature prophet, seek close relationship with the Lord. Because the Lord is who? Is the tree that produces prophecy. The Lord is the tree that produces miracle. The Lord is the tree that produces power. The Lord is the tree that produces everything. Then when you seek relationship with the Lord and you become his friend, what the Lord knows, he will share with you. Amen? What he knows, he will share with you. So some of our prayer, we are praying, is not happening because we don't know the purpose of God. What James say? He said, we are asking, we are not receiving because we are asking for your selfish ambition. Amen? For your selfish ambition. But if you are not asking for your selfish ambition, but therefore you are asking for the purpose of God, then why God will not do it? Amen? So close to the Lord gives you more prophecy. Close you are to the Lord makes you a reservoir of power. And mature prophet, do not seek money. Because as we say, prosperity, money, being capability. So when you are close to the Lord, you have capability. Because what God cannot produce, what God cannot achieve, you have everything. So close to the Lord makes you capable of everything. Amen? So the understanding of Jesus, or the understanding Jesus had of the Father, makes the Father put everything at his disposal. Because he knew the purpose of the Father. He understands the purpose of the Father, so the Father can give him power, the Father can give him prophecy, the Father can give him everything, wisdom, everything. So, if the church is lacking in the prophetic, the church is not mature in the prophetic, it's because the church is lacking the understanding of the plans and the purpose of the Father. If, look, we saw the power Moses demonstrates. Amen? What the Bible say about Moses? Psalm 103, verse 7, say what? God showed his ways to Moses. And just the deed to the people of Israel. God showed his ways to Moses. So Moses knew God's ways, God's plans. Amen? To the point that Moses knew who God is, he can talk to God for God to change his plan. Amen? For God to talk to his plan. So until we understand that we are on earth for the fulfillment of the dream of the Father, we can never reach our destiny. Because our destiny is the portion of the plan God has for us within his plan. Amen? The portion God has within his plan. So, if God promised something to you, it's not happening. It's because you have not changed your mind. Understand something. Let me tell you, a lot of people pray. Say, Father, open my eyes. Open my eyes. But now, when you are saying, every time you are saying, open my eyes, something is in your heart that is different. Because you have a plan. Do you know that Jesus' eyes was opened? He was full of power. Though he was full of power, he didn't heal everyone he encountered. he met. Amen? That means when your eyes is open, you must ask God, open my eyes. Therefore, I can be able to see what you see and do what you want me to do. But if emotions are still in you, when you see something immediately you want to run. Sometimes God just wants to show you, and that's it. He will show you, but he will do nothing. He says that the time of trouble, when he was in Matthew 24, when the time of darkness was coming, what does he say? A great darkness was announcing. He said, let your heart not be troubled. That means not let you don't get emotional about those things. But follow me. Amen? So, Daniel, I want us to check something. Daniel 11 verse 12 say, verse 32. Daniel 11, 32. He said, those who do wickedly against the covenant, he shall corrupt with flattery. But the people who knows their God shall be strong and carry out exploits. He said, those who do wickedly, amen, against the covenant, he shall corrupt with flattery. If you look at it today, those who are flattering, okay, when they go to church, you say, oh, God will give you this. They say, hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, amen. Are they doing good? What are they doing? Nothing. God cannot use them. But those who know their God, when you know his purpose, then you can do exploits. Amen? With him. That's Daniel 11, 32. Amen? So, knowing God, understanding God, knowing his purpose. But another pride today in the church is that the little everybody knows, say, I know God. Nobody can fool me, I know. Okay? If you know what's coming out of you, tell us you know. You must not judge by what you say, you must judge by your fruit. What are the fruits? Amen? So until you know and understand and become one with the plan of God, godly cannot be seen through you. Amen? But now I want us to understand something and link something together. God said to Haggai, amen? In Haggai 2:9, say, the future glory of this temple will be greater than the past, its past glory, said the Lord of heaven's army. And in this place, I will bring peace. And I, the Lord of heaven's army, have spoken. That means the glory of the latter day church will going to be higher. Okay? But now look at what Daniel said as well. He said, but you, Daniel, keep this prophecy a secret. Seal it up. Amen? Or seal up the book until the time of the end time when many will rush here and there and knowledge will increase. Knowledge will increase. When you say knowledge will increase, knowing the things of God will increase. People will understand better God. Amen? When Daniel went to Babylon, how many were they? According to the record of the Bible, there were four, isn't it? In the palace. At the end of the day, what happens? The king made a decree saying that everybody should worship the God of Daniel. Hallelujah. He didn't have a team of evangelism here. Okay? But look at what happens. Daniel 5 verse 12 says, this man Daniel, whom the king named Belshazzar, has exceptional ability and is filled with the divine knowledge and understanding. Exceptional ability. That exceptional ability are coming from the understanding he knows about God. When you understand God, God produce something exceptional after you. So it's more than just knowing what God is going to do.
He said, the people of Israel, what God told them, I'm taking you somewhere. They follow, they see the deeds of God. But did they understand God? If they did, they should have not been rebellious. Hallelujah. So, brothers and sisters, we need to understand faith is more than just having confidence in what God will do. Anything you hear up to now as a prophecy, start asking God. Or even you saw yourself in the dream doing, start asking God, what is the purpose of that? It's good, you like it, yeah? Fine. What is the purpose of that? Father, what do you want to do with it? Why do you want to use me to do that? How will I manage it? Is there anything in me that makes me not qualify yet? What shall I do? Then he knows that, yes, you are dedicated. Some of us, sometimes we are tempted. The enemy will send some people with some plan, and we fall and say, oh, this is a good deal, good deal. But God is testing you, allowing the enemy to throw things at you. Amen? So, brothers and sisters, seeking God and becoming passionate about Him is what is required. And then, when you become passionate about God, you will be astonished. Because the ability and the things God will throw at you, God will realize, you will be shocked yourself. Because He's saying, what eyes have never seen, ear have never heard, or never cometh out of our understanding, this is what God will do to you. This is what God reserved to those who love Him. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, hey. Don't worry. We trust God. Amen. We trust God. So, when you hear this today, I believe this can be able to change your life. Amen. This can be able to change your life. Start looking, seeking, understanding the plan of God. And even today, 2015, what God wants to do. If you are seeking God, God, give me what I want to do. Give me the gift you gave to Moses. My friend, what God wanted to do at that time is then. And the people of that time, their culture, they don't need the same thing. The way they think is not the same. But God can respond to every culture, every generation. So seek God fresh. Hallelujah. That's why I always say the Bible is introduction to God. We must not copy. Okay? Out of the Bible, God will create something new, tangible, powerful in you. Because this generation today, what God wants to do, He never did it for anybody. Like when I told you, we went to heaven, the angel was on my left like this. And they would do like this, new building will appear. And when they finish the event, that building will disappear. A new event, they'll do like this, new building will appear. Big building, everything just, it's not like it's built, it just appears. Wow. Okay? I won't say it's in the second or fraction, I don't know. But it will just appear, wow. And you know, the angel told me, God is doing this with some mature ones. Okay, no problem. So we must seek maturity. Hallelujah. And the word mature means you understand things of the adult. Hallelujah. Because it's not every adult. Let's say you understand life. But it's not every adult that is mature. That one we know. But somebody who's mature is somebody who understands life. Amen? But now when we are talking about understanding life in the spiritual, that means you understand the life of God.
how God works, what he likes and what he doesn't like. Amen? Hallelujah. God bless you.